Welcome to a Mechanical Engineering YouTube channel. Today in this video I will explain all the interview questions regarding material science. So the first question is, what is alloy? So alloy is a combination of two material or more than two material in which materials does not lose its identity and they will show their property in alloy, like Fe and carbon and Pb and Sn, in which both iron and carbon will show their property, and Pb and Sn also, Pb and Sn will also show its property. And NaCl is not an alloy because NaCl is like salt. So salt mein sodium and chlorine lose its own identity and they does not have any property in NaCl. So what is mean by iron carbide diagram? Iron carbide diagram is a graph between temperature and carbon, in which we obtain different phase of iron by changing either temperature or percentage of carbon. So this is iron carbide diagram, in which 750 degree centigrade and 1150 degree centigrade, these are the five phase of iron: alpha ferrite, gamma austenite, delta ferrite, and Fe3C is the cementite, and one more phase is martensite. Iron carbide diagram does not show, and martensite phase is shown in the TTT diagram that we will see in the further. What is eutectic and eutectoid reaction? So eutectic reaction, in which liquid convert into two solid, this is eutectic reaction. And eutectoid, solid convert into two solid. So in if it is the case of iron carbide diagram, so liquid convert in gamma and Fe3C, this is eutectic, in which iron carbide diagram. So and in eutectoid, solid gamma austenite convert into alpha and Fe3C. So if I tell you eutectic reaction, so this point is the eutectic reaction point, in which liquid, when we decrease the temperature of liquid, so liquid convert into two solid, gamma and Fe3C. They all are solid. Gamma is solid, Fe3 is solid, delta is solid, alpha is solid, all are solid. L is means liquid. So this point is a eutectic point, and eutectoid point, this point is a eutectoid point, in which gamma convert into two solid, alpha and Fe3C. So this region is the alpha plus Fe3C. So this is eutectoid, alpha plus Fe3C. And the fourth, tell me the total number of phase of iron. So in iron carbide diagram we obtain the total five phase of iron. So iron have five phases. So in which five phases, one is alpha ferrite, gamma austenite, delta ferrite and cementite. So these four phase we can see in the iron carbide diagram, but fifth phase, that is martensite, we cannot see martensite in iron carbide diagram. Martensite, if you want to see in martensite phase, then you have to draw the TTT curve. And fifth question is, at what temperature eutectoid and eutectic reaction occur? I already told you that eutectoid reaction occur at 750 degree centigrade and eutectic reaction occur at 1125 degree centigrade. We can also see this in iron carbide. So this is 1125 eutectic point, this is eutectoid point, 750 degree centigrade. So you must have to remember the temperature also. And now what is TTT curve? TTT curve is a temperature, T stands for temperature, time and transformation. So what is the main difference between TTT and iron carbide diagram? So in iron carbide diagram we only change temperature and percentage of carbon, we only change percentage of carbon temperature, but in TTT curve we also change the time. And by changing the time means, how we can change the time? Just keep your mixture for a time of period, so in which you will observe the different phase of iron transformation. So phase transformation will occur by keeping the mixture for a certain time or period of time. So this is TTT curve, in which we obtain martensite phase. I already told you in martensite is obtained in TTT diagram. So the question comes in our mind that how martensite is formed. So martensite is formed in TTT curve, but how? So we take a mixture of gamma austenite. We take the mixture of gamma austenite, and keeping this gamma austenite for a constant time ke liye gamma austenite ko rakh dijiye, and critical cooling rate is required, and we cool this gamma austenite at faster cooling rate. faster cooling rate means greater than critical cooling rate. So why doing this type of cooling we can obtain Martens cycle. Now I will show you the TTT curve so you can understand very well. So this is the TTT curve. It is looks like C curve. So here we have gamma austenite. So if you cool this mixture at this is the critical cooling rate when it touches the nose. So this is the critical cooling rate. So this is your temperature. This is your temperature and this is the time. It is the graph between temperature and time. So this much temperature decrease in this much of time. This much temperature decrease in this much of time. You are understanding? So this is critical cooling rate. This is a very faster cooling rate. If you are increasing the critical cooling rate, that means you are doing this much cooling. So gamma austenite is cool at a critical cooling rate, then you will get the martensite. If you are decreasing your critical cooling rate, means you are doing cooling like this, so you cannot get martensite, you will get pure light. And this is the going through inside this curve, then you will get bainite. Okay, and now most ductile, most brittle and most strong phase of iron. So remember this, most ductile phase is gamma austenite. Most ductile phase is gamma austenite and most brittle phase of iron is alpha ferrite, and most strong and hardest phase is your martensite, because martensite is obtained at critical cooling rate or greater than critical cooling rate. So if you are doing this kind of critical cooling, this kind of cooling, then you will definitely get a strong phase or hardest phase. Now question is, what is critical cooling rate? I already told you, critical cooling rate means. So see this diagram. I have drawn two lines, this line and this line. So you tell me in which line has greater cooling rate, this line or this line. So this line has less cooling rate because in which this much of temperature is decreasing in this time, means you are requiring more time of period. And in this, and this line has greater cooling rate because this much is temperature is more in decreasing very less time. How much time is required? This much time is required. So this is the cooling rate. And what is mean by critical? Critical means this line will curve the nose, means it will curve TTT diagram. If this line is touching the TTT curve, then this will mean by critical cooling rate. And if you are increasing critical cooling rate more than, if you are increasing your cooling rate more than critical cooling, that this has the greatest cooling rate. So if you want to obtain martensite, that means you have to, your cooling rate will be more than critical cooling rate in this region you will get martensite. So here is gamma austenite and here is martensite. Understood? And the 10th question is, what is annealing? So annealing is just a heat treatment process. And why heat treatment process is required? Because we are obtaining our material from either TTT curve and iron curve diagram. So why, when we obtain our material, so this have some toughness is high, okay, in some case hardness is very high. So you cannot use this material in the engineering application, because martensite, if I give you an example of martensite, so martensite is the most hardest phase and the brittle also. So you should increase its toughness like heat treatment. So how we will increase its toughness? By using annealing. So annealing is a heat treatment process in which you just heat your material and change its properties. And fine and coarse, which structure is hard, means fine jada hard hoti hai coarse. So you always remember, fine structure is always strong compared to coarse, because in fine structure you are having more grain boundaries. And when you have more grain boundaries, so your movement of dislocation will resist more because you are having more grain boundaries. And what is mean by strength? Strength is just the resistance in the path of movement of location. If your dislocation is resisting more, that means your material will automatically strong. So fine is always more strong than coarse. And what is normalizing? Normalizing is again a heat treatment process in which our main purpose is tough core and hard surface. This type of material we form in normalizing. Means if I give you an example of sphere, so we want that hard surface, our surface should be high and our core should be tough. So this type of material is formed in normalizing process. So how we will obtain hard surface? I already told you, whenever we require hard surface, your cooling rate should be more than critical cooling rate. Like martensite, martensite is hard. Why it is hard? Because in martensite cooling rate is greater than critical cooling rate. So how we will obtain hard surface? By increasing the cooling rate. And tough core means already if you want tough, then means critical cooling rate will be less, your critical cooling rate should be less. And what is tempering? Now tempering is again a heat treatment process. In tempering, just we heat our material. Tempering is the heating of material. Why we are heating of material? To change the property, to increase its toughness and softness. So these are the some of the important interview questions regarding material science. So if you like this video, please give a like button and also subscribe my channel if you are a mechanical engineer. Thank you for watching. If you have any doubt regarding this question, please do comment and tell me. Thank you so much for watching this video.